it's an election year. What has happened when you militarize a state? When you militarize a state, the thing that happens is people lose their identity and they lose their capabilities of making democratic decisions. You see, it's hampering the identities of people to make sound democratic decisions. And if we see in many militarized states, we have seen it in Uganda with the dictatorship, it is very much linked to dictatorship. Even in North Korea, if you do understand the politics that's happening there, you do know that the people there are restricted a lot. So is this the type of environment that we are creating? So if this is the case, then as LPM, we will bring in the United Nations to investigate this issue, because it's really coming, it's going out of hand. We also question the type of stats, the statistics that they used in order to come up with this, that Namibia is in a state of anarchy, because that's the only way that really they can come into these measures of the NDF and bringing them in to control a situation that has been erupted into violence, where society does not know peace. We really need to question, as society, does the NDF and the Namibian forces, are they really protecting our lives if they are the ones who are the perpetrators of violence? The architecture of top levels, which are the NDF and the Namibian police, are the ones that are in streaming violence, and one could speculate that this violence would translate into society normalizing this violence and later institutionalizing this violence. What I mean is that this operation, if it's not handled cautiously, if it's not handled with human dignity, it could be the very cause of retaliation. It could be the very cause of an eruption of violence.